Hello mga ka-Elion, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Sir DL and welcome to the Elion's Vlog and Math Tutorial. For today, we are going to have another tutorial that's all about quadratic equations by quadratic formula. Solving quadratic equations by using quadratic formula. Objectives: discuss quadratic equations. Number two, solve quadratic equations using quadratic formula. And number three, find the values of x by quadratic formula. Always remember, it is better to do your best than to be the best. Again, it is better to do your best than to be the best. What is quadratic equation? A quadratic equation is a second order or second degree polynomial equation in a single variable. The standard form of a quadratic equation is ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0, where a should not be equal to 0. The graph of a quadratic equation is a parabola. So let's now try to solve a problem using quadratic equation by quadratic formula. So given the standard form ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0, where a is not equal to 0. Our formula, x is equal to negative b plus minus the square root of b squared minus 4 multiplied by a multiplied by c over 2a. That will be our formula to be used in order for us to be able to solve quadratic equation by quadratic formula. Let's try to have an example. Given x squared plus 4x plus 3 is equal to 0, there are steps to follow. Number one, identify the values of a, b, and c. So, values of a will be beside x squared, value of b will be beside x, and our constant will be our c. Value of a is 1 because there's 1 beside x squared. Value of b is 4. Value of c is 3. Number two instruction, substitute the values on the given formula. So we have here now negative b, that is b is equal to 4, b squared, that is 4, 4, value of a is 1, value of c is 3, value of a is 1. So we will be substituting the values on the given formula. That's the second step. Third step, we multiply. That is 4 times 4. Then 4 times 1 times 3, then 2 times 1. Again, 4 times 4, then 4 times 1 times 3, then 2 times 1. What is 4 times 4? That is 16. 4 times 1 is 4 times 3, that is 12. 2 multiplied by 1, that is 2. That is the third step, multiply. Fourth step, minus. 16 minus 12. That is 4. 16 minus 12, that is 4. Bring down this one and this one. Next step, square root. We will be finding the square root of 4, that is 2. So we have here negative 4 plus minus 2 over 2. That is x is equal to negative 4 plus minus 2 over 2. Next step, separate the two variables. Or two values, I'm sorry. Separate the two values. We have here, since we have plus minus here, we will be separating them. So negative 4 plus 2 over 2. And the other one, x sub 2 is equal to negative 4 minus 2. Again, we will be separating the two values. So x sub 1 will be negative 4 plus 2 over 2. Then x sub 2 will be negative 4 minus 2 because we have negative 4 plus minus 2 over 2. That's why we will be separating the two values. Add or subtract, it depends. So on this part, negative 4 plus 2, we have the similar sign. So negative 4 plus 2 is negative 2 over 2. Then negative 4 minus 2, that is negative 6 over 2. Next, divide or get the lowest term. Negative 2 divided by 2, that is negative 1. X sub 2 is equal to negative 6 divided by 2, that is negative 3. So the values of x are negative 1 and negative 3. Another example, 2x squared minus 5x plus 3 is equal to 0. Steps to follow, number 1, identify the values of a, b, and c. The value of A is 2, that is beside x squared. The value of B is negative 5, that is beside x. And 3 is C, that is the constant. Then substitute the values on the given formula. This will be our formula. Do not forget this formula. So we have B is negative 5, B is negative 5, A is 2, C is 3, A is 2. Next, multiply. So negative times negative, that is positive. Negative 5 times negative 5, that is 25. Negative 4 times 2, that is 8. Times 3, that is 24. 2 times 2, that is 4. Negative 1 times negative, positive 5. Negative 5 times negative 5, 25. Negative 4 times 2, negative 8 times 3, negative 24. 2 times 2, that is 4. Next, we minus. 25 minus 24, that is 1. 25 minus 24. The next one, square root. What is the square root of 1? That is 1. So we will be moving on the next process. So that is x is equal to 5 plus minus 1 over 4. Our next step is to separate the two values. So 5 plus 1, then 5 minus 1. We will be separating them. So 5 plus 1, 5 minus 1, divided by 4. Add or subtract. That is 5 plus 1, that is 6, over 4. 5 minus 1, that is 4, over 4. Next process, divide or lowest term. X sub 1 is equal to 6 over 4. X sub 2 is equal to 4 over 4. So 6 divided by 4, we need to find the lowest term. 6 divided by 2, that is 3. 4 divided by 2, that is 2. So x sub 1 is 3 over 2. One of the values of x is 3 over 2. 4 divided by 4, that is 1. So the values of x are 3 over 2 and 1. Next example, 4x squared minus 4 is equal to 0. Steps to follow. Number 1, identify the values of A, B, and C. Value of A is 4. There's no value for B. Value of C is negative 4. So the value for B is 0. Substitute the values on the given formula. So we have B, which is 0. B, 0. Then 4, that is the value for A. Negative 4 is the value for C. Then A is 4. Multiply. So 0 times 0 is 0. 4 times 4 is 16. Negative 4 times 4 is negative 16. Times negative 4, that is positive 64. 2 times 4, that is 8. So we have here 0, 0. Negative 4 times 4 times negative 4, that is 64. 2 times 4, that is 8. Then add 0 plus 64, that is square root of 64 or 64. Then square root. What is the square root of 64? That is 8. So 0 plus minus 8 over 8. Let's move on the next process. We have here 0 plus minus 8 over 8. So we will be separating the two values for x sub 1 and x sub 2. X sub 1 is 0 plus 8 over 8. X sub 2 is equal to negative 0 minus 8 over 8. Add or subtract. 0 plus 8 is 8 over 8. 0 minus 8 is negative 8 over 8. Then divide or lowest term. So 8 divided by 8, that is 1. Negative 8 divided by 8, that is negative 1. The values for x are 1 and negative 1. If you will be checking, if you will go back on our given example, we have here 1. 4 multiplied by 1 squared, 1 times 1, that is 1 times 4, that is 4 minus 4 equals 0, that's equal. So that means our answer is correct. Next example, x squared plus 6x plus 8 equals to 0. Steps to follow, as simple as what we did a while ago. Identify the values of A, B, and C. Value of A, 1. That is 1 beside x squared. Value of B, 6 beside x. And the constant is C, that is 8. Then substitute the values on the given formula. So that is B, B, A, C, A. Negative 6 plus minus the square root of 6 squared minus 4 multiplied by 1 by 8 over 2 multiplied by 1. So next process, multiply. So 6 times 6, that is 36. Negative 4 times 1 times 8, that is negative 32. 2 times 1, that is 2. Again, 6 times 6, that is 36. Negative 4 times 1 is negative 4 times 8, negative 32 over 2. Next, subtract. 36 minus 32, that is 4. 36 minus 32, that is 4. Then square root. Square root of 4, that is 2. We can move on the next process. We will be separating the two values because we will be having value for x sub 1 and x sub 2 because we have here my plus and minus. Negative 6 plus 2, negative 6 minus 2. Add or subtract. Then negative 6 plus 2, based on the rules of integers, unlike sign, we add, we subtract, then we follow the sign of the higher in terms of absolute value. Negative 6 plus 2, that is negative 4. Negative 6 minus 2, that is negative 8 over 2. Divide our lowest term. X sub 1 is equal to negative 4 over 2. Negative 4 divided by 2, that is negative 2. Another one, x sub 2 is equal to negative 8 over 2. Negative 8 divided by 2, that is negative 4. So the values for x are negative 2 and negative 4. Another example, steps to follow. So the one of the examples, 3x squared plus 2x minus 2 is equal to 0. Identify the values of a, b, and c. Value of a is 3. Value of b is 2. Value of c is negative 2. Substitute the values on the given formula. So we have b, that is 2. Value of a is 3. Value of c is negative 2. Value of a is 3. Multiply. 2 times 2, that is 4. Negative 4 times 3, that is 12. Times negative 2, that is 24. Then 2 times 3, that is 6. So 2 times 2, 4. Negative 4 times 3, negative 12. Times negative 2, 24 over 2 times 3, that's 6. Then add 4 plus 24, that is 28. 4 plus 24, that is 28. Then square root. Square root of 28. 28 is not a perfect square. So we will be finding factors which are perfect, which are factors of 28, and one must be a perfect square. So we have here 4 times 7, that is 28. And 4 is a perfect square. So this one will be negative 2 plus minus the square root of 4, that is 2, square root of 7 over 6. Let's move on the next process. Separate the two values. Values for x sub 1 and values for x sub 2. So we have negative 2 plus minus 2, the square root of 7 over 6. That's why we have negative 2 plus 2, the square root of 7 over 6. Then negative 2 minus 2, the square root of 7 over 6. Add or subtract? We cannot combine this one. We cannot combine. Because we cannot combine irrational numbers without this. We can only combine irrational numbers in terms of addition if we have the same irrational number. So we will just be getting the lowest term because negative 2, 2, and 6 are divisible by 2. Negative 2 times, negative 2 divided by 2 is negative 1. 2 divided by 2, that is 1. 6 divided by 2, that is 3. Another, negative 2 divided by 2 is negative 1. Negative 2 divided by 2 is negative 1 again. There's automatic 1 on this side. Then 6 divided by 3 divided by 2, that is 3. So divide our lowest term, that is the final answer already. Because we cannot divide and we cannot get the lowest term because we did the lowest term a while. So that ends our discussion for today. Always remember to trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge Him or submit to Him, and He will make your path straight. This is Sir DL. Thank you for watching, and God bless you. God loves you. Always remember that. Bye.